Hey class, welcome back to the lab videos for this semester. In this video, we're going to be reviewing the standard proctored test and seeing how we can use the standard proctored test to find the optimum moisture content through creating the compaction curves. Okay, first things first, we have to mix our dry sample with the initial 6% moisture by mass. So if this is 3,000 grams-ish of soil, this is gonna be what? 180, okay, I gave you guys the answers. Okay, so we gotta mix that in our little container, and this is gonna be a part where we need to make sure that it's consistently mixed throughout, because we need to make sure that everything we're mixing in our proctor mold is going to be of the same moisture content. So this is going to take a little bit. Just bear with me as we go through this. Okay, so now that we have our soil magically mixed with our initial 6% moisture content, we need to fill it in our proctor mold now. So we've already taken the empty mass without the collar of the proctor mold, and we've also already taken the empty masses of our moisture cans. This is moisture can one. This is the only one I'm going to be showing in this video. Did it for the other two as well, and you can see that in the data spreadsheet. So again, this is our hammer that we're going to be using, 5.5 pound drop, height of 1 foot. And we're going to be filling our mold in three layers, even layers-ish, with 25 blow counts of this guy each time. final layer, we need to make sure that it's filled all the way up, because we need to make sure that the bottom mold is completely full. So that's why we need to have more, and then we'll use a straight edge to cut it off and make sure that it's completely filled. Okay, so it's been compacted in three layers with 25 blow counts each. You can see there's a lot of just residual soil all around the outside. We need to make sure that all of this soil is taken off of the mold before we take the weight. Because again, we're assuming that all the mass is taking up the volume of this inside mold right here. So we'll take the collar off, we'll cut the straight edge and create the, and then brush off the outside, and that will be our mass that we can then take divided by this set volume of the mold to create, or to find our moist density. Okay, so we got a straight edge. You can see it's cut straight at the top. We use the straight edge to get a good even surface as best as we could. And we tried to clean off the outside of the mold as most as we could too. So the collar, again, we're not going to weigh right here when we take our M1, our mass of the compact, or the mold filled with compacted soil. So again, we have our mass of our mold with our compacted soil sample in it. We try to clean it off as best as we can. I'm gonna go and take the weight of this, but remember, to find the density, we have to subtract the mass of the empty mold that we took previously. So let me do this, I'll give you the number, and then we'll take the moisture content. Okay, so now we need to take a sample out from this to verify that the moisture content was about 6%. Remember, the 6% was just a kind of starting point, initial thing. We need to calculate, and or we need to measure the actual moisture content, and what we're going to be plotting on our x-axis of our compaction curve is the actual moisture content. So again, we have our little handy moisture can. We need to take a sample out from this, put it in the oven, and then measure the mass before and after the oven, assuming that the water is going to be all evaporated out at when we take it out of the oven. Okay, so that's probably all I'm gonna show for this lab at least. The benefit of doing this virtually is you guys don't have to sit through the three other trials that I have to do with this. Now what we would do is mix the remainder of this sample back with our initial sample. We would add about 2% of moisture by mass to bump that up to roughly 8% moisture content. And then we'd have to do the whole thing over again. So compacting it again, taking another M2, and then we'd also have to do moisture contents as well. So take another sample for 2, 3, and 4. And again, that's going to be theoretically around 8, 10, and 12%. The reason why I'm starting there is because I've done this test before with this soil. So I know roughly where the moisture content should be, the optimal moisture content is. Think about it though, if you were doing this in the field or an actual engineer with some soil you've never worked with before, it would be completely trial and error. So you'd have to keep bumping up the moisture content until you start seeing that curve go down a little bit and you start seeing the density go down as we increase the moisture content. So that's gonna be it for this video. Remember though, there's 4 total trials. So you need to have 4 moisture contents, you need to have 4 densities, and you need to plot that on the moisture content x-axis, dry density, y-axis, and then you should be able to see that little peak. Where that peak is the optimum moisture content. So make sure to write down that optimum moisture content and the respective dry density unit weight in pounds per cubic foot.